welcome everyone to the another class of microbiology online course. We will discuss today the electron microscope. This is more versatile instrument. It is actually the most sophisticated kind of a microscope in the order to observe the very minute object or particles or the bacteria or the viruses. So as its name indicates, it uses the electron instead of a light in the order to have the fine details of the bacteria or the object. So since the dependency of the researcher have been progressively needed to form the more fine detail structure of the objects, most particularly in case of a viruses, which cannot be observed by the light microscope. So the researchers, they have started to use the electron as a source of light to focus the object. Okay? So therefore, generally we use the electrons instead of light. Why we need to do this? Because the electrons, they actually behave same as of the light, right? Because in a vacuum, they travel a straight line direction and falls under the sample, right? They have the wavelength as of the light, okay, which is 100,000 times smaller, okay, smaller than the visible light. So the much smaller the wavelength is, the high definition image of the object can be produced. So therefore, the electrons is more preferred over the light because of its very less smaller wavelength. And the electron, they can behave as the same as the light or the mirror, because the effect of electric field and the magnetic field is the same on the light as well as in the electrons. Therefore, the electrons can be used as of a light, right? So these are the factors why we use the electron instead of the light, right? See, electron microscope, it is what it actually uses the beam of electrons, okay? So to create the image of the specimen. Since it has the very smaller wavelength, therefore it has the high magnifications, right? Magnification we already studied, that is the increase in the size of object can be done, okay? So high magnification is there because of the electrons, and the resolving power is the much more larger than the light microscope. Okay. So these are the reasons that why we use the electron microscope. Okay. So as a definition, what we can call electron microscope, it is the microscope we use the beam of electrons, okay, which has the higher magnification and the higher resolving power, okay, to observe the fine details of the smaller minute objects, right? In fact, they are large and the expensive than the compound microscope. Generally, it actually require a room size structure to fit this whole structure. Okay? Light microscope, it is handy. It can be moved from one place to another place. It is a smaller one, right? See, in case of we see the difference between these two microscope, light microscope uses the light, that is the common tungsten lamp, okay, which has the longer wavelength. Here we will use the electron as a source of light, which has the very short wavelength. Size is small, it is quite bigger and cannot be movable, right? Inexpensive, of course, this is expensive because it is a large structure and so many sophisticated lenses are being used, that is electromagnetic lenses. Okay, anyone with a few practice can be used this. Okay, yahan pe we need a very massive training. Okay, color image can be seen. Yahan pe only the black and white image are produced because we are using the electrons instead of the light, right? Specimen can be studied live or in a dead condition, but the specimen yahan pe hoga is always dead because we are keeping the sample into the vacuum. Okay, so there must be the date of a sample, right? So generally we use the unlike species of an object. रिजोल्विंग पावर लो होता है, यहाँ पे वी विल हैव हायर रिजोल्विंग पावर, लोअर मैग्निफिकेशन, वी विल हैव द हायर मैग्निफिकेशंस, राइट? सो दिस आर द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन द लाइट माइक्रोस्कोप्स एंड द इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप बिकम मच मोर मोर सोफिस्टिकेटेड एंड यूजफुल दैन द लाइट माइक्रोस्कोप, राइट? See this here, we can check out the various size of object that can be observed by the eyes, that is the unaided eyes, the light microscope, and by the electron microscopes. Okay? So up to this particular range, we can see through our naked eyes. Okay, but to see the much smaller things, then we will need the light microscope. Up till now, till the microplasma, we can see with the light microscope, but to see the viruses, right, or to see the internal structure or the internal organelles of the cells, proteins or the lipids, then the chemicals, okay, and the small molecules and even the atoms, okay, we need what? We need the electron microscope, right? So this is what very fine minute objects, even the atoms or the molecules, can be visualized by the electron microscope. In case of epilepsy, the Dr. Ernst Ruska and the Max Naun, okay, these two people, they have built the first electron microscope in the year 1931. Okay, and for this work of them, they have been awarded the Nobel Prize for the same in 1986. Right, so this is Max Naun and the Ernst Ruska. They have, in fact, invented this electron microscope. See, there are two types of this electron microscope. One is the transmission electron microscope, that is called the TEM, okay, the most short form. The second is the scanning electron microscope, that is we call it as the SEM. Okay? So these two different types of electron microscopes are generally the prototypes of the main electron microscope. Here you can see this is what the complete structure of electron microscope, which is quite a bigger and then massive structure, which require a complete one single separate rooms for its attachment, right? So we will see this, the first electron microscope, that is the transmission electron microscope. Now this transmission electron microscope, as it here we can see this, such a huge structure, okay, with fitted with the different types of its components here, okay. So there are several different components attached to this particular electron microscope, and each component, they have their own individual functions or role in the order to focus the objects, right? So we'll see this individual objects, mostly important components. Here yahape we will have the electron gun, okay. So electron gun is actually the outermost top part of this particular area, where we will keep the electron gun. What is the electron gun? It actually consists of cathode or anode or a heated filament, okay, that produce the electrons, okay, when we give the electric current of a particular high voltage, they emits the electrons, right? Then second we have the condenser lens, okay. Condenser lens is actually what? It is the kind of electromagnetic coil, okay, which focuses the electron beam. Okay, ye electron beam kahan se aayega? It is coming from the electron gun. Okay, so condenser lens focuses the electron beam onto the sample or the specimen. Right. Third is what we have. It is the objective lens. Objective lens again, it is kind of electromagnetic lens. Okay, which produces the first magnified image of the sample, okay. And the projector lens is what? Projector lens is another electromagnetic lens, okay, which magnify the first image which is produced by the objective lens. Yani yahan pe objective lens jo pehli image produce karega usko magnify kon karega? Projector lens, okay. So ye hai aapka condenser, and yahan pe there is a sample, okay, sample, and this is what your objective lens. That means the electrons which are produced by the electron gun, they travel like this, which falls onto the sample, okay. Sabse pehle condenser se jayega, fir sample pe girega, then सैंपल से इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑब्जेक्टिव लेंस में आएगा, ये पहला प्रोड्यूस इमेज यहाँ प्रोड्यूस करेगा, देन इलेक्ट्रॉन दे विल मूव टू द प्रोजेक्टर लेंस। प्रोजेक्टर लेंस क्या करेगा, ऑब्जेक्टिव लेंस की पहली इमेज को मैग्निफाई करेगा, फोकस करेगा, ठीक है। फाइनली वी विल कम टू दिस पार्ट, दिस कॉल द स्क्रीन, ओके, जहाँ पे इमेज हमको देखेगी, द फ्लोरोसेंट स्क्रीन आर द फोटोग्राफिक फिल्म। ओके, व्हाई वी नीड टू यूज दिस, बिकॉज आवर आईज कैनॉट ऑब्जर्व द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, ओके, बिकॉज वी कैनॉट सी द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, देयरफॉर वी नीड द सर्टेन फ्लोरोसेंट स्क्रीन इन द ऑर्डर टू ऑब्जर्व द इमेज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ इलेक्ट्रॉन। सो यहाँ पे आपको दिस इज व्हाट इज द फोटोग्राफिक फिल्म ऑन द फ्लोरोसेंट स्क्रीन वेयर द फाइनल इमेज will be produced, okay. So these are the five different important parts of the electron microscope. First is what is the electron gun, condenser lens, objective lens, projector lens, and the fluorescent screen, okay. So we'll see the mechanism of each and every component, what will happen, okay. When we turn on the electron gun, okay, that means when we give the electric current to this electron gun, electron gun generates what? They generate the number of electrons, that is called the beam of electrons. Now these beam of electrons then pass through, कहाँ से pass होगा? Then pass through the condenser. That means electrons से यहाँ से वो नीचे आएगा, comes to the condenser. ठीक है? Since the electron cannot pass through the glass lens, so हम क्या use करेंगे? Magnetic lens. That is more important. Okay? So यहाँ पे objective lens जो होगा वो magnetic lens होगा, not the glass lens, because glass lens cannot is opaque to the electrons, right? So magnetic lenses are used to focus the electron. So once the electron move from this electron gun, falls onto the sample yahan pe, right here. So one more important thing is what, we have to create a vacuum, or we have to maintain the vacuum inside the whole structure, because the movement of the electrons will be deflected by the इससे the air, okay? यानी कि whole this structure we have to keep under the vacuum, okay? ये पूरा का पूरा system जो है हमको vacuum में रखना पड़ेगा, यानी बाहर से metal frame जो है वो हमें attach करनी पड़ेगी, okay? So the electron travels, okay, in a straight line direction onto the sample in presence of वैक्यूम, दैट इज एयर नहीं होना चाहिए, एयर होगा तो द मूवमेंट ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन विल बी स्कैटर्ड, राइट। सो द इलेक्ट्रॉन फाइनली दे फॉल्स ऑन टू द स्पेसिमन, ओके, एंड देन स्पेसिमन से इलेक्ट्रॉन जो है वो विच इज फोकस बाय द मैग्नेटिक इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक लेंसेस, ओके। सो यहाँ पे इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक लेंस रहेंगे, मैंने कहा था अभी प्रोजेक्टर लेंस, वो प्रोजेक्टर लेंस क्या करेगा, सैंपल से पास होके आने वाले इलेक्ट्रॉन्स को मैग्नीफाई करेगा, एंड फाइनली आपको एक इमेज देगा फ्लोरोसेंट यहाँ पे नीचे सबसे, ठीक है। सो इमेज आपको मिलेगी कुछ ब्लैक, कुछ डार्क, कुछ लाइट, इस प्रकार से मिलेगी, बिकॉज ऑफ व्हाट, सम सेल ऑर्गेनल्स विच हैव द हाई डेंसिटी, ठीक है। सो हाई डेंसिटी से जब इलेक्ट्रॉन जाएगा तो दे स्कैटर मोर, ठीक है, देयरफॉर दे अपीयर डार्क, एंड सम अपीयर ब्राइटर, जिनकी डेंसिटी कम होगी, यानी इलेक्ट्रॉन को वो ट्रांसपेरेंट होंगे तो दे अपीयर ब्राइट, ठीक है। सो आपको यू विल सी दी डार्क एंड ब्राइट इमेज बिकॉज ऑफ द पासेज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इन टू दैट पर्टिकुलर डेंस पार्ट ऑफ अ सेल, ठीक है। सो दिस इज व्हाट द एग्जैक्ट मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप, ठीक है। इलेक्ट्रॉन गन से इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आएंगे विच फॉल्स ऑन टू द सैंपल, सैंपल से इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रोजेक्टर लेंस यानी इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक लेंस वो स्क्रीन पे डालेंगे, स्क्रीन पे आपको इमेज मिलेगी, ठीक है। सो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ें हैं यहाँ पे ऑब्जेक्टिव लेंसेज, ऑब्जेक्टिव लेंसेज दे आर मेड अप ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक लेंसेज, नॉट द ग्लास लेंसेज, ओके, बिकॉज द इलेक्ट्रॉन कैन नॉट पास थ्रू द ग्लास लेंस, ओके, देयरफॉर वी नीड द मैग्नेटिक लेंसेज, दैट इज द मेन बेसिक डिफरेंस, राइट। सो इन दिस वे द होल मैकेनिज्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप इज एक्चुअली वर्क्स। सो दिस इज व्हाट एग्जैक्टली द इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप, यू कैन सी दिस होल स्ट्रक्चर, this is whole structure, this is actually a metal frame, okay, to maintain the vacuum inside, right. It has on the top, it has the electric gun, then here it is what, it is the condenser hai aapka, this is what, this is the objective, that is electromagnetic objective, at the bottom here you can see this is the eyepiece through which we can observe the image which is present or produced yahan pe on the fluorescent screen, right? So this is what the X-ray image of this whole structure, right? So the image will produce will be of like this, okay, black and white image having certain dark and brighter areas, okay, dark and brighter areas produced because of the transparency of the electron to the dense part of the cell organelles or the different part of the cells, okay. So in this way the whole electron microscope is actually works, okay? So this electron microscope you can see here, okay, such a huge structure, okay, which is completely enclosed in a metal frame, okay, to which attach the different parts of this. This is what the photographic film where you in the eyepiece where you can see the film or the object, right? So what exactly happened? The beam of electron which is produced by the cathode here, okay, which transfer beam of electron transfer to this thin sample. Yahan pe sample rahega. Beam of electron will transfer like this, falls on the sample. And sample se aane wale electron then focused by what? Focused by the electromagnetic lens, which falls again onto the fluorescent screen bottom end, right? So you will get the image like this, black and white image, that is the more clear image, okay? So when you put the sample, okay, between the condenser, okay, so electron beam they passes through and falls onto the sample, okay, and finally reach to the fluorescent screen yahan pe, okay, and fluorescent screen mein, there you will get the final image here. So this is what exactly the working of the electron microscope, right? Second most important is what is this scanning electron microscope. Now this scanning electron microscope is actually scan the whole surface or area of the object with a high energy beam of electrons, right? So mostly what in this electron the signals that is produced by the sample surface topography. Topography means what? It is the surface area of the any object, okay? So by this electrons we generally get the design of the surface area of the object. Also we can study the composition or any other properties, okay? So scanning electron microscope mein generally we scan the surface area of a bacteria, okay, in the order to produce three dimensional picture of a final object. So three-dimensional image can be produced with the help of a scanning electron microscope. So this component here, which are very similar to the transmission electron microscope, here what we have electron gun that produces the electrons, which consists of cathode and the anode, right? Condenser, it is again electromagnetic lens, okay, that takes the beam of electron and falls onto the sample, okay? Then objective lens. Objective lens, it focus the beam into the spot on the sample. That means they focus the beam of electrons onto the sample. Diffraction coil is there, that is the electromagnetic lens or projector lens, which deflects the electron beam, okay, towards the final image or the photographic film. There is another devices or detector that is called secondary emitting device, okay, which capture the scattered electron, okay, that is the secondary electron. What is the secondary electron? We will see in the next slides. Also the detectors can detect the X-ray, okay, that means all the electrons which are scattered. So scatter mein secondary electron rahenge, X-rays rahenge, these secondary and X-ray electron will be detected by the different types of detectors attached to the microscope, okay. So this is what it is, yahan pe electron gun hoga, this is condenser, okay, this is deflection coil, helps the deflection of electron beam to the final lens, that is here, okay. Aur fir ye jo electrons hai, yahan se electrons kya honge, we will have the X-rays or we will have the secondary electrons. This X-ray and the secondary electron will be captured by the electron detectors, and these electron detectors amplify the signal, and on a computer screen you will see the final image, right? So see the mechanism. This is what, this is the electron gun, okay, when electron gun electrically heated, they produce the electron beam, that is the beam of electron will be produced. Okay, and this beam of electron then travel through what? Then travel to the different lenses, electromagnetic lenses. सबसे पहले वो कहाँ से जाएगा? वो जाएगा कंडेंसर से एंड देन ऑब्जेक्टिव से. ठीक है. सो फाइनली दिस बीम ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विल फॉल्स ऑन टू द स्पेसिमन. स्पेसिमन आपका रहेगा बॉटम में सबसे. ठीक है. सो दिस इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक लेंसेस हेल्प्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम फॉल्स ऑन टू द सैंपल. ठीक है. जैसे ही सैंपल पिघलेंगे, दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन दे स्कैन द सरफेस ऑफ द स्पेसिमन. सो स्पेसिमन क्या करेगा? जो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आ रहे हैं उसको एब्सॉर्ब करेगा और उसको कन्वर्ट करेगा किसमें? सेकेंडरी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स में. ठीक है. दैट इज दे प्रोड्यूस द और इमिट द सेकेंडरी इलेक्ट्रॉन. नाउ दिस सेकेंडरी इलेक्ट्रॉन देन डिटेक्टेड एंड कलेक्टेड बाय द डिटेक्टर. दैट मीन्स यहाँ से दिस इज व्हाट, दिस इज द सेकेंडरी इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड दिस सेकेंडरी इलेक्ट्रॉन देन डिटेक्टेड एंड सेंड टू द monitor to produce a picture, right? So this is ultimate working of a scanning electron microscope. Here one thing we have to remember, that the primary electron which is produced from the electron gun falls onto the sample, sample absorbs that electron and emits this secondary electron. Secondary electron then captured by the detector in the order to produce the image on a computer monitor. So exactly what happened like this. Okay, when the electrons from the electron gun falls onto the specimen yahan pe, okay, specimen kya karega? They absorb the electron. Okay, kuch electrons jo hai wo transmit ho jayenge niche, kuch electrons hai diffract ho jayenge. Okay, kuch electron bacteria khud emit karega, usko kya bolenge hum? Secondary electron. Some electrons they get scattered, उसको बोलेंगे back scattered electron. Some electrons get deflected in a visible region. Some electrons get deflected into the converted into the X-ray. Okay? So many types of the electrons are produced as a secondary electrons, and all these secondary electrons will be captured by the detector, right? So this is what exactly happens when the electron strike onto the sample. Okay? So this is what exactly the electron transmission microscope, scanning electron microscope, where the cathode gun or the electron gun produces the electrons, okay, falls onto the sample. So this is electron beam which is passes through the magnetic lens. Okay, this is magnetic lens, condenser lens, deflection lens, scanning coils, okay. And here is the sample. Okay? So the beam passes through a pair of scanning coils and the detectors in the electron column. Okay? So this passing through the objective lens, they passes finally to the sample. Sample pigne ke baad they scattered like this, right? Okay? So some will X-ray, some will unscattered ray, and see this was secondary rays. Okay? Wo diffract ho jayenge. Now these diffracted rays will be detected by the detector and an image will produce on a screen. Okay, on a screen monitor. So these beam of electrons when falls onto the sample, secondary electrons will produce and these secondary electrons will give the image here, right? So once these secondary electrons scan the whole area, you will get the different image like this. Okay, so they scan different whole area. So by scanning and detecting the number of electrons, okay, we can produce the three-dimensional image of a object. Okay, so this is what exactly the scanning electron microscope picture. Okay, which give the fine details of the object. Okay, which produces secondary electrons, and secondary electrons will be detected by the monitors. Right. So finally, the application in case of this. As I told you, it gives the three-dimensional picture of a object, or the topography. That means the surface image also can be produced. The working is very fast, right? And the data we can store in the digital form. Since the image you get in a computer monitor, you can save it in the digital form, right? The things are very less in the order to prepare the sample. Okay, the minimal preparation is required. Okay, and some steps like dehydration and the fixing of the sample, which is the main step in the transmission electron microscope. यहाँ पे आपको सैंपल का डिहाइड्रेशन नहीं करना होता, फिक्सिंग नहीं करना होता. वी कैन यूज द सैंपल डायरेक्टली. सो दिस इज द मोर एडवांटेज ऑफ द स्कैनिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप, राइट? सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप वेयर वी हैव अंडरस्टैंड द बेसिक्स ऑफ दिस, दैट वी यूज द इलेक्ट्रॉन इंस्टेड ऑफ द लाइट, एंड देन वी यूज द इलेक्ट्रिक मैग्नेटिक लेंसेज इंस्टेड ऑफ ग्लास लेंसेज. ओके, देन टू टाइप्स, ट्रांसमिशन इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप एंड द स्कैनिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. सो दिस इज व्हाट कंप्लीट अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. होप दिस इज ऑल अंडरस्टैंड टू यू. वी विल कंटिन्यू द नेक्स्ट क्लास विद द न्यू टॉपिक. ओके, फॉर नाउ थैंक यू.